is a temporary process. It's a short, a quick process, and it is governed by the Adjudication and Construction Payment and Adjudication Act.
Malaysia is basically in competition with other regional or other countries' arbitration center. How do you market KLRCE overseas?
I think I have to clarify that we are in competition. Actually, all the centers in Asia are working together to promote arbitration and dispute resolution in Asia. I think we work with our friends in Singapore, in Hong Kong, in Korea, in China, and we have formed, I'm the president of APREC, which is the Asia Pacific Arbitration Grouping. And we foster arbitration, and we try to bring back all the arbitrations that are going on in London, in New York, and we all want it to come back to Asia. But you're quite right, within Asia itself, we have a number of centers. Of course, the famous centers are Singapore, in Hong Kong, and Kuala Lumpur Regional Center. Even Australia has its center. But the way we try to differentiate this ourselves is our products, and also our cost effectiveness. That means, I think when a person chooses the center, he will have a number of things why he must come, why he chooses Kuala Lumpur to arbitrate. So it could be first the cost factor. The second, that the judiciary is supportive of arbitration, that you have a legal system, the legal profession is vibrant and is just as good as anywhere in the world. Then we have our specialized products, which is world class. So this is the way we market ourselves. And the other centers are doing similarly, and they market the virtues, and we downplay our difficulties.
Right.
Amirul HM and Datuk Sundra Raju will discuss more on KLRCA rules, so stay tuned while we take a short break. Last segment of Islamic Finance Today, Dato' Sundra Raju will brief us about the KLRCA rules and services. Some of the rules and services are: first, KLRCA Arbitration Rules 2010; second, KLRCA I Arbitration Rules; and finally, KLRCA Fast Track Arbitration Rules. Let us view this interview for a better understanding about the KLRCA rules and services.
During the recent 3rd Global Islamic Finance Forum in September, the KLRCA launched the I-Arbitration Rules. Why is there a need for such a rule to be launched?
Thank you, Amirul. It's a very good question. The Malaysia is actually one of the market leaders where Islamic finance products are concerned. In fact, Sharia compliant products are the order of the day. And Bank Negara, when we launched it, because Bank Negara has been a great promoter together with the Securities Commission of such products. What the history of such a product is that Kuala Lumpur Regional Center did have Islamic arbitration rules in 2007. And in 2007, that set of rules was only used for domestic arbitrations. So as we internationalize, and the I products are, especially the sukuk bonds and the takaful derivatives, are all being marketed around the world, there was a great need to come up with a dispute resolution mechanism which is modern. And I think, you know, you cannot actually have a method of marketing new products which are very complex in structure, and when the disputes arise are complex in nature, that they have to be resolved only in the courts. So parties, we thought, would prefer arbitration. Hence, we came up with the KLRCA I arbitration rules. And this set of rules is unique. It's 2 years in the making. We gave it great thought. We consulted a number of scholars. We did a lot of research. We debated. And what was the approach that we should take? And the approach that we decided was to have a truly international set of rules which is based on UNCITRAL arbitration rules, which is the most widely used ad hoc arbitration rules in the world, and modify them. Modify them, and then we introduced a Rule 8 under the KLRCAI arbitration rules, Rule 8, which allows for reference to a Sharia advisory council or a Sharia expert where there are issues involving Sharia.
I would say another question would be, in order to become an arbitrator in Islamic finance, is it just limited to Muslims or Sharia scholars? What are the qualifications needed to arbitrate a matter on Islamic finance under the I arbitration rules?
We expect the person to know about the contract itself. That means you must have basic competence or very good experience and training in interpreting contracts, really such kind of contracts. The second thing is that you must know the arbitral procedure, how to conduct an arbitration and to write an arbitration award. So there is no strict requirement that the arbitral tribunal will have to be Muslims. So, but because they can refer this to the Sharia Advisory Council or to a Sharia expert, that part is taken care. At the present moment, in KLRCA, we have 500 international arbitrators. All of them, including the Malaysian, with another 200 Malaysians, will become eligible. But of course, you know, we do allow parties to decide on their own arbitrators. Sometimes, and in the past, under such kind of arbitrations, we have had very, very eminent jurists, Muslim jurists and non-Muslim jurists, and arbitrators sitting and deciding, and parties have accepted the decision. It has been very successful so far.
That's an interesting approach adopted by KLRCA.
The third segment about KLRCA rules and services brings us to the end of this episode. It has indeed enlightened me about the differences between going to the courts and going to the arbitration. That's all for the Islamic Finance Today program in this episode. If you have any comment or suggestion, please send us an email to islamicfinance@capitaltv.my or visit us on our Facebook page, www.facebook.com/capitaltvif.